Hi there and welcome back to Japan, where we're checking out a little bit more Silent Siren today, the fun pop rock band who really play their own instruments and have a wonderful ability to balance on the edge of cheese whilst also being extremely, in my opinion, credible musicians. So today we're checking out a song which I'm not sure how they want us to say this. It can't be OdoreMotion because it's an O, not an A. So even though it's not spelled exactly the way for this, it does kind of look a bit more like OdoreMotion. And you should never call a song OdoreMotion. If your odors are motioning, something is wrong. But anyway, here we go. This is OdoreMotion? OdoreMotion. Sorry. So you put Japanese with English and you don't put a space in there, then I'm going to get confused. Here we go. Let's call it OdoreMotion. Go. Wow. Gee, I feel like I'm caught in one of those early 2000s screensaver desktop things. Actually, great visuals, really cool. Adore. There's my other headphone. It's very kinetic, the way it's written, the way it moves. I can see there's like a video game tie-in going here or something. This hook is really a grower, isn't it? First time round, I was like, Second time already, I'm really getting into that hook. Great break there. Oh, that's the end. Wow. Oh wow, that was 2.5 minutes. That went quick. 2.5 minutes is a good length of time for like a pop rock or a pop punk song, I guess. I mean, remember, you go back to like the days of 60s rock and roll and you wouldn't get a song that breached 3 minutes in most occasions. You know, most of them were around about 2 minutes. So that was fantastic. I can't believe they packed in so much there. I mean, that kind of left me wanting more. Brilliant. The hook was a real grower. Only came around twice. It was very, like I say, with them and many other Japanese artists, there's a lot of attention to detail, which is a fantastic thing. But one of the things I really noticed there was the drum breaks were brilliant. I was trying to work out in my head, are the drum breaks too much? Because they were quite coming thick and fast. But like I say, maybe that song is, even over its short time, is a grower. Like at first you're kind of listening like, okay, where's this going, where's this going? But by the end I was totally sold on that. It was quite a long journey. Opinion wise for 2.5 minutes, like I say, at the beginning, sort of thinking, okay, there's a lot going on here. That's one of those ones where I immediately, like right now, want to go back and listen again, which is, I heard someone say this years ago in a really good music review, and it was actually Come Back Around by Feeder. And if anyone knows, Feeder, obviously the British band who had, you know, sort of built up fame over a while, and then they had a huge album, Echo Park, with Buck Rogers and all that, and loads of like really famous singles on it. And then they did a follow-up album, which was in the time between, they'd had like their drummer unfortunately had passed away in like really tragic circumstances and all kinds of things, and they came back and their lead single single was a song from the next album, was a song called Come Back Around. And the one thing that a lot of people said is it had that strangely infectious quality where at first you're thinking, where's this going? It's not immediately doesn't immediately grab you, but then by the end you just really want to play it around straight away. It's just one of those songs where the minute you finish, you're like, got to listen to that again. And it had a very immediate stop at the end, a lot like this. So in a way, this kind of reminds me of a lot of the things I liked about that. That song, the tonally very different songs, but, you know, it also had that kind of stoppy-starty thing going on there. There was a lot of attention to the drums, as with their story would kind of make sense. So in a way, I'm kind of getting a feeling, although they're totally different songs, this kind of reminds me of a lot of the reasons I liked Come Back Around by Feeder, which could be too much of an obscure reference for a lot of people listening, so I'll probably move on from that. But yeah, if you like your sort of accessible but interesting pop rock songs, that's a definitely one to check out. But yeah, this had a lot of detail and interest in it, and it stuck to their normal vibe of being kind of upbeat and, you know, not too emotionally challenging. It is a shame that I do need to find some of their older videos, and I don't think, unfortunately, I've got any lined up at the moment. I have heard some of their older videos have a little bit more tension in them, but it is interesting that Silent Siren never seemed to transmit anything that has any tension to it, which is kind of a shame because it means from a mood aspect, a lot of their music has, as I was mentioning before, that feeling where it almost could be seen as being backing music because it kind of doesn't engage too much of you on an emotional level, except for just for sort of happiness. So it's the sort of thing you kind of put it in a, like a, I said this before, like a summary sort of playlist, a happy playlist, and maybe that detracts from the fact that it's actually really good music. But yeah, there is a quality to the songs, and this one is a really good example of that. This is one of those ones where if you just want to really engage with something quite happy and fun, there's a lot going on in there. I'm looking forward to listening to that again and picking out a lot more of the details. There were some interesting changes with the drums towards the end. The drum did a little thing where it seemed to like double time a little bit, and the bass was great actually. There's some fantastic bass fills in here that you really should go and check again. I mean, well, I say again, a lot of you probably picked them up all perfectly the first time around, but there was some great bass stuff in there actually, which was fantastic. A lot like their peers, a lot of guys were mentioning to me after that whole bandmate dancing to Silent Siren Quino Esper video, a lot of people mentioned that they're actually good friends, and so now I'm sort of mentally I am thinking about some of those comparisons. And it is interesting that as a band both of them seem to have a lot of detail on the bass and drums. And yeah, so there was a lot of those little details in here which were great. I thought that was a really good song, and I think it was one that it would push back against any one of those people who tries to take them for granted. But like I said, I think they're probably their biggest enemy is that none of Silent Siren's songs up to this point seem to have any emotional tension to them, which is probably one of the reasons why some people don't take them seriously on the same level. But yeah, I'm enjoying it. That was great, that was short, and the video was fantastic. Lots of little fun details in that as well. I liked the way that, you know, a lot of the time when you've got a promotion tie-in, it can really detract from a video, and you can end up with a video where you're trying too hard to put stuff in that doesn't belong. There was a really good example of getting it right, which was one of the passcode videos. I need to go back and do more passcode soon, actually. But one of the passcode videos, I think it was Taking You Out, something like that, and it was like tied in with like some sort of app racing game, and they did a fantastic job of making that work in the context of the video. And this was another example of it kind of working in that they kind of putting the girls in, do we call them girls or ladies or women? I don't even know what the proper term is, you know, when you're in a pop band. The sort of putting them in the visuals of the video game and then just interspersing that with a bit of the game just kind of made it sort of work. If you don't know anything about the game, it is kind of confusing, but if you just sort of take it as a visceral thing, it's like, looks cool. I hiccuped just as I was doing that, which is really awkward. Anyway, so yeah, This one, like I said, doesn't add, and just in sort of conclusion, doesn't seem to add any new emotional weight that we haven't seen from them before. It's interesting to see them doing such a compact and kinetic song. They're always very detailed, but this seems to really almost force it down into a more condensed package, which is really enjoyable to see. And visually, the video is great. It brings something interesting to the table. One thing which is interesting is I'm starting to notice more that as much as I compliment the drums, that sort of disco beat, the what I call it sort of like a disco shuffle, the kick, hat, snare, hat, kick, hat, snare, hat, like a sort of thing. I can't beatbox, but you kind of get what I'm going at there. That seems to come up in a lot of their hooks. I'm hoping that isn't too much of a mainstay, because as good as that is, you don't want to completely base all of your hooks on that. So I'll be paying a bit of attention to if they keep on pulling that drum beat out too much. But otherwise, yeah, no, really enjoyed it. Great. Another example of them kind of doing their thing, still managing to give each of the songs identity, maintaining their sound without making their songs all sound the same. So good stuff. Anyway, looking forward to hearing more. Going to dive into another Silent Siren very soon. So for now, from Japan, you can go back and listen to old ones, or you can wait for new ones. Either way, for now, ciao, ciao.